whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. With a smile in his soul, he is... And now that his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light. With a smile in his soul, he descended Mount Cuthbert, cheerily blowing hoo-hoo on his trunk. Rode into Whoville. He brought back their toys. He brought back their poof to the Who girls and boys. He brought back their snoop and their tringlers and fuzzles. Brought back their pantookas, their dafflers and wuzzles. He brought everything back, all the food for the feast. He himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast. Welcome. Bring your cheer, cheer to all who's far and near. Christmas Day is in our grasp, so long as we have hands to clasp. Christmas Day will always be just as long as we have we. Welcome Christmas while we stand, heart to heart, hand in hand.
Dr. Seuss's imagination had no bounds.
The Grinch bees mean and selfish.
He has a cactus, you're as
hideous teeth, stinky breath.
You're a bad banana.
I first discovered the Grinch in our bookshelf. I thought he looked like some sort of weird mutant chimpanzee or something.
TV sensation. The story was more of a bookish persuasion. With the Christmas tree up and the stockings all hung, this tale would be told by the old to the young. So break out your kazoozles and give it a cheer, for 2007 is the book's 50th year. To have the crystal Christmas, give a salute, but somebody wrote and drew pictures to boot. For his real name, Ted Geisel, he just had no use. You know him much better as the good Dr. Seuss.
Dr. Seuss was born Theodore Geisel in 1904 in a small town, Springfield, Massachusetts. And the main thing that I think is so interesting about Dr. Seuss is that he wasn't born Dr. Seuss. It was a long process of him finding that identity.
I think Dr. Seuss is a cat in the hat. I think Dr. Seuss is a rhymer.
I think Dr. Seuss is a writer and an illustrator.
His mother, Henrietta Seuss, always wanted her son to be a doctor. That was her biggest goal. She wanted him to be Dr. Geisel. When it came time for him to publish his books, he wanted to get that doctor sound that his mother had liked. And he also used her maiden name, Seuss. When he was little, he started doodling and drawing on everything. He was actually voted by his college class least likely to succeed because they said, a man can't exactly doodle for a living.
In his first art class, he was holding the artwork upside down and looking at it for composition reasons, and it
was unpleasant. Around the whole room, he took every present.
Seuss always had the ability to connect with his own child inside, and children that read his books connect with that.
Dr. Seuss wrote.
These were stories that amused him, that he, of course, he knew that children read them and loved them. But he said, write what seems to appeal, be amusing to you, and you hope they like it.
And their shrieks, squeaks, and squeals racing round on their wheels. They'll dance with jing tinglers tied onto their heels.
Seuss was always asked, where do you get your ideas? And he hated that question so much, he came up with an answer. And his ideas came out of Uberglitch. And that's a town outside of Switzerland, I believe, where he would go every year to have his cuckoo clock fixed. And while the clock was being fixed, he would mingle among the townspeople, and they would give him his ideas. And you never really knew if Seuss was telling the truth or not, because he hated straight answers.
The fantastical places we wanted to...
But for 53 years I put up with it now. I must stop Christmas from coming. But how?
No.
Seuss was the Grinch in some ways. It was part of his alter ego.
The hoo-ha. And he's up there being grumpy.
Yeah, he has two sides, but the nice side is shy.
I think the Grinch could be a bad person, sometimes a good person.
I think there's fun seeing the Grinch.
So he's got to stick with him.
I think Whoville's in Alaska, because it's always snowy.
I think that Whoville is in the Arctic Mountains.
I think Whoville is make-believe.
The characters of the Whos.
He was coming back from